Hello and welcome to Driving with Todd, and I'm Todd. I was at the grocery store the other day and I found the latest issue of Mojo magazine. At least this is the latest issue in the United States, and it has the monkeys on the cover, and that drew my attention immediately. Now, I don't buy Mojo often. Maybe the last issue I bought might have been 10 months ago, but I had to have this issue because of the monkeys. Well, I was reading it today and I came across a letter to the editor that in a previous issue, maybe two issues back, they had an article about Nuggets from 1971. And the person mentions Emitt Rhodes and the Flaming Groovies. And it's like, yeah, I love those two bands in the 70s. I mean, I just really liked Emitt Rhodes and I liked the Flaming Groovies. So this is kind of cool that they're mentioning that in the Nuggets article from 1971. It was all these kind of lost groups that nobody listened to back then. Well, I must have been weird because I listened to them. But how did I get to like Emitt Rhodes? Well, Emitt Rhodes, he's an American musician. He's a songwriter. He's a singer. He's a producer. He's an arranger. I mean, he does everything. And what happened was he was in a band in the 60s and they kind of folded. And he wanted to do more music. So he had a home recording studio in his house and he recorded every single instrument for the songs that he was putting together. He took a tape, it was a four-track tape of these instrumentals and went to Dunhill Records and played it for Dunhill. Well, they said, yep, let's do this. We'll do a contract. Let's finish up the songs. So then he transferred those tapes to an eight-track recorder and added the vocals on the other four tracks. So he put out this album called Emitt Rhodes in 1970. It was December 1970. He had one single off of there that actually broke the top 100 on Billboard's 100 Hot 100 singles chart, and that was Fresh as a Daisy. It got to number 54. But how did I hear about Emitt Rhodes? It wasn't from the Fresh as a Daisy single. I don't even remember that one on the radio, but it did get pretty far on the Hot 100 list. Well, I was recording, and I've told this on many, many other videos I did. I was recording FM in the evening onto a reel-to-reel tape deck, and then the next day I'd listen. Well, the next day after I did some recording, I heard this song, and it was called Live Till You Die. And here I thought it was McCartney. I mean, it sounded like Paul McCartney. And I'm going, did Paul McCartney put out another single that I didn't know about? I mean, that's how close he sounded to McCartney. And what's kind of funny about it is 1970, McCartney released a solo album. And what did he do? He recorded that on a four-track reel-to-reel as well. So here's two guys, one in the UK, one here in the United States, doing the same thing, recording in their home studio and releasing an album. And very similar sounds. But I just love the song, Live Till You Die, found the album, got the album, played it, and went, I love this album. This guy is really talented. So I thought it'd be fun to listen to and talk a little bit about Live Till You Die by Emitt Rhodes. So here we go.
I have to say the things I feel.
Singing
Yay. This is a great pop song. I mean, the whole album, this whole first Emitt Rhodes album, and this is the cover of the album, what's on the video here, is a great pop album. I mean, the guy has some really good hooks on this song and throughout the whole album. I mean, the beginning is just great with that beginning acoustic guitar and the bass in here. I mean, the bass is just like really up front, which I really, really like because I'm a bass-driven guy. But the lyrics are kind of cool too, and they're just kind of great lyrics. They just kind of grab you and bring you into the song. And the way he uses the melody, it's like you don't want to turn it off. You want this song to like go on forever. Just really well put together song. And it's interesting that he did this all himself. I mean, production, recording, the whole thing. Writing, the whole thing. Very talented. Let's start this back up again. You must feel to be alive. You must live till you die. That's a great song. The only thing I miss in that song, it's a 3-minute song, but the only thing I miss in that song is that there's no instrumental break. It'd be kind of cool if they would have done some sort of instrumental break, either with the acoustic guitars or the keyboards he was using. Something, you know, for, you know, 30 seconds would have been great. But it's a beautiful song. Great song, great pop song. And, you know, as I was reading on the internet about this, I always look into things before I do a video like this. And I'm not the only one that thought that Emitt Rhodes sounded like the Beatles or Paul McCartney. They said that that's what kind of drew people to him, is he was like the second coming of the Beatles. I don't know, that might be taking it a bit far, but he does have that sound, that really nice pop sound that McCartney does on many of the Beatles songs and then on his own solo stuff. Just really love this song. This was also a single. It was his third single. It was Fresh as a Daisy. Then there was another song off the album, and then there was Live Till You Die. It didn't break the Hot 100, though. It got to like 103 or something on Cashbox, but never broke the Hot 100 on Billboard or on Cashbox. But it's a great song. I'm really surprised it didn't, because it's got such a great melody and the lyrics are kind of cool, and it just kind of just floats along. The song just kind of floats along. And that bass in there, I mean, it's just booming. I love the bass on this song. So I hope you enjoyed this. Going back to like 1971, listen to Emitt Rhodes do his thing, his studio work that he did every piece of this song, from writing to playing to singing to producing. The guy is very talented. So if you really like this, if you like Emitt Rhodes doing Live Till You Die, put it or hit the like button. That'd be really cool. If you have any comments about Emitt Rhodes, Live Till You Die, the first album, Emitt Rhodes, which is just a great album, put it in the comments. That'd be really cool. And if you haven't done so, please subscribe to my channel. Just hit that subscribe button. I'd really appreciate it. And if you ring the bell, you'll get updates to my latest videos. So I'm hoping this put a big smile on your face. It was fun to listen to this again. I'm glad I saw that in the magazine. It put a smile on my face, but gave me some memories back to 1971, and that's always fun in itself. So peace out, baby.